Hello students, today I'm going to explain your history chapter 4, that is the making of a global world. The topic I'm going to explain, the first topic here is the pre-modern world. Students, do you know that when we talk of globalization, automatically it comes to our mind that it is an economic system. Because of globalization process, there are more interconnectedness of national economies of various countries of the world. We know that globalization is a process of interactions and integrations of people, of economies and government of various parts of the world. But do you know that globalization has also its own history? In this chapter, we are going to study about the history of globalization. Okay? That is, the making of a global world has a history. History of trade, of people, of migration of people, of flow of capital, and so on. Who were the people who moved from one place to another? Various types of people, travelers, traders, priests and pilgrims. Why would they move from one place to another? For various purposes, for trading purposes or for gaining spiritual fulfillments or for higher enlightenment, etc. So when they moved from one place to another, along with them, they carried their skills, their knowledge, their traditions and cultures. Sometimes they also carried diseases along with their bodies. Do you know that for more than a millennia, cowries or seashells were used as a form of currency instead of money in various parts of the world? And in those days, cowries were found abundantly in our Indian oceans, collected from the Indian oceans to our Indian Ocean islands and Maldives, and then spread to various countries such as China and Africa. Okay, so this is the introductory part of this topic, pre-modern world. Let's move to the next subtopic, that is Silk Routes Link the World. What are these Silk Routes? Silk Routes were the various routes which connect China with other parts of Asia, from Asia with Europe and northern part of Africa, over the land and by the seas. Why the name Silk Route was given? Because in those days, famous Chinese silk cargoes used to travel from China towards the Western countries. Apart from silk, pottery also used to travel from China towards Western countries. And do you know that from India, what were the things that traveled towards the West? Textiles and spices. Okay? Now, in return from Europe, gold and silver came back. Okay? Now, trade and cultural exchange always went hand in hand. With the flow of exchange of these commodities, there was also exchange of culture. If we take religion, which is an expression of culture, it is believed that Buddhism emerged from Eastern India. Through this route, it is spread to different parts of the other countries. And after Buddhism came the Christian missionaries. A few centuries later, after Christian missionaries traveled through these routes, came the Muslim religious preachers who used to travel through these routes. So this was about the Silk Route. Let's go to the next topic, that is subtopic, that is food travels, spaghetti and potato. If we take an example of cultural exchange that have taken in those days, we can take an example of food, both ready-made as well as raw food. For ready-made food, let's take an example of noodles. It is believed that noodles originated in China, okay, spread to the West to become spaghetti. Likewise, Arab traders brought pasta from Asian countries, and then it is spread to Sicily, which is an island in Italy. Nowadays, people think that pasta is an this Italian culturally rich food. But when we study history, it was found that it was brought by Arab traders. But you know, students, at that time, when China were using these noodles, Noodles were also used in other countries of Asia, such as India and Japan. So these things which I have told are all presumption, and their exact origins can never be traced back. Okay? Now, if we take an example of other food stuffs such as potato, tomato, okay, some of foodstuffs, I would like to mention potato, tomato, chilies, soya, and okay, wheat. Okay, these foodstuffs, these crops were not known to our Indian ancestors 5 centuries before. Then how do we come to know in today's world about this foodstuff? Only after Christopher Columbus discovered America in 1492, after that it is spread to Asia and other parts of Europe, and then we are able to eat these kinds of foodstuff. Okay, sometimes students, do you know that a new crop, after the introductions, it became so dependable that sometimes it could make the difference between life and death. So if we study the Irish potato famine, which occurred in mid-1840s, what happened at that time, after the introduction of potato, okay, in Europe, that is, Ireland is in Europe, a country, okay, the poor peasants became so dependent on potato that when the famine broke out in the mid-1840s, hundreds of thousands of died of starvation. This is the end of this subtopic. Next subtopic we will discuss in another video. Thank you.